Hi, my name is RP Ergonza. I'm the owner of Ergonza International Trading. And we're here today to give you some business tips kung paano magtayo ng sarili mong pizza shop. So this is our office. This is our admin office. Here we have Sir Eldrick. Hi, Sir Eldrick. Mag-hi ka naman.
Hello.
Okay. So ang Ergonza Trading or Ergonza International Trading is a supplies company na nag-provide ng products, supplies to businesses all over the Philippines. Businesses like coffee shops, tea shops, grills, restaurants, etc. So mostly food and beverage, although we do have other clients as well na hindi naman nasa food and beverage. So since 2012, we've been here. Pero back then, I was still a business consultant pa lang. So how it started was, wala talagang supplies company before. So it was just my consultancy firm, wherein, like what I said earlier, I opened businesses for people. And somewhere along the way, merong mga medyo sumaya sa services namin, asked to retain our services for the entire year. And somewhere in there, may mga kliyente rin na nagsabi na if possible na kami na mag-provide ng ilang products nila. I guess that's where that started to transition into trading. Okay, pero like what I said earlier, the unique thing about sa amin is we never really forgot our roots. So as business consultants, hindi porke nagbebenta na amin ng products, eh, we shied away na from our consultancy practice. What we did is we tied both together. So as we supply you, we teach you the business as well, and we help you grow it. I never finished school, actually. I'm an undergrad. Si Chris is not, but he took a long time finishing school. So what happened was, nagtayo ako ng milk tea shop way back before 2010-ish, 2011, ganyan. And I was one of the very first na meron sa Philippines. Somewhere along the way, somebody asked me if they could franchise my brand. And back then, I didn't know kasi how to franchise things pa. I didn't know how that worked. So parang I gave them an offer na, if you want, I'll teach it to you na lang. And you can pay me. And believe me when I tell you, super cheap pa ng singil ko back then. Kasi I didn't know yung mga singilan and etc. And sa awa naman ng Diyos, yung tao na to, medyo sumikat. Became a big brand. And because of their popularity, medyo nahatak ako. Nagkaroon ngayon ng mga tao wanting me to teach them my business as well or that business as well. And then slowly, I learned other things and then brought that into the consultancy part as well. So to be honest, yung pagiging business consultant ko at that time was sort of biglaan lang. I didn't really set out to be a business consultant. That's just what happened along the way. So to give you an idea, we cater to some of the brands na you are probably well aware of. So if you were to go into a mall right now, some of the top cafes and tea shops that you would see in a mall right now, some of them would be our clients. And you know, medyo masaya naman ako kasi they've been with us for a very long time. Even the very first one na binanggit ko kanina, until now 11 years na, and they're still with us. So as I mentioned earlier, we also provide business packages, one of our best-selling business packages is our coffee shop business package, wherein we provide everything from espresso machines, commercial grinders, commercial blenders, all the way to the execution part of the business, meaning how to operate, how to make your own coffee, and etc. Okay, we also have other business packages available, such as pizza business package, flavored fries, milk tea, coffee, ramen, but it's currently on hold, and other consultancy packages as well. So Chris is my longtime friend. We've known each other since college days pa. And when medyo na-allow na ako ng panahon mag-bring in ng better talent, I asked Chris if he wanted to join me in this venture, and lucky for me, he said yes naman. Okay, so let's go to the second floor to Founders Cafe Incorporated. The hold business trainings here, business workshops, even business coachings in this part of the shop. Yung part doon, that is the retail side of the business. That's called Founders Donuts. The difference ng training namin sa ibang mga training na makikita mo sa labas is most training centers na makikita mo in or around the market right now are places na tuturuan ka kung paano ka maging barista. For example, kung coffee shop training to. Kami here at Founders, the goal is to teach you how to become a coffee shop owner or a business owner. Not a barista, but the person running the shop itself. So we not only will we teach you paano maging barista, but we will also cover everything from, like, for example, costing, pricing, business strategies, marketing, etc. We will be covering all of that to make sure that when you start your business, you are as prepared as possible. Okay, so for today, we're gonna give you guys a sneak peek on how we do our pizza business workshop. And from here on, moving forward, Chris will be the one to show you the ropes.
Para alam nyo yung flow ng workshop, we usually start off ng first introduction. So, konting history lang sa pizza. Saan ang galing? Paano napunta dito? Second part is the ingredients. Ano yung mga ingredients kakailanganin ninyo to make, of course, New York-style pizza? Third is equipment. So, what equipment do you need to start your very own pizza shop? Fourth is going to be majority of the training, or the majority of the workshop, actually. This is yung hands-on portion. Gagawa tayo ng pizza dough from scratch. Then gagawa ng pizza, stretching, tossing, and then usually sa training namin, we make somewhere around 8 to 10 pizzas. So talagang masasanay talaga kayo. And then fifth is going to be the business discussion. So there, pag-uusapan yung negosyo, magkano ang kitaan sa pizza shop business. First. Okay, water. We put our yeast in. So this recipe, somewhere in 3.75. That's fine. Okay. Next, we add in our honey. So we do this because we want to activate our yeast. Yeast is a live organism activated by heat and by sugar. In this case, our sugar is our honey. Oops. I was hoping for 20 grams, but oops, that should be fine. Make sure again our yeast will be activated. The first thing we do, kasi it takes a while for it to be activated. Usually, mga 5 minutes, depending kung gaano kainit yung lugar. So, sisilipin natin kung ang honey, lahat ng melt, or lahat ng mix. Salt, we're gonna put 20 grams. Okay. Then, olive oil. Sorry. There you go. Okay. So, for the mixer here, we're using planetary. There are different kinds of mixers. Yung mga iba may spiral. It just depends on the quantity that you're making. We have a dough hook. I'm a mix. The goal here is kailangan yung tip ng hook to the end, it should be around this far. Okay, so really close enough na may mix talaga na lahat. Let's try. Of course, we'll go into more detail in the training, especially when it comes to making bigger batches. Okay. So we are just waiting for this honey's mixture. We want to make sure first that the yeast is alive. So we have to wait for about, again, 5 to 10 minutes. It's usually people who want to start their own business. I'd say kalimitan around 70% first-time entrepreneurs. So, syempre, simula, medyo kinakabahan. There madaming kailangan malaman, or sometimes nag-YouTube sila. So, bandaming kaalaman sa YouTube. Hindi alam kung ano yung susundin. So, usually those are the majority. And then, siguro mga 30% would be galing sa ibang industry. So, for example, beauty industry, gusto nila mag-food, yeah, saka sila pupunta sa amin. Usually, yung classes namin kasi, it's smaller groups. So, we don't like yung tipong 20 kayo nandito. We like it very small kasi we want everyone who to get experience in actually doing what we're teaching. Unless magkakilala. So, if big group, lahat sila magkakilala, then 6 people, it's okay. Then we'll accept that. But usually, they only have, let's say, 3 people, something solo, which we don't mind. For pizza, it would be 6,000 for one, 10,000 for 2 people. Everything is covered. So, really, the idea is you'll know how to start and run the business after you finish the training, the workshop. So, FWs that, so nakita kami sa Facebook, habang nandun sila, nag-research sila. And then, pag-uwi dito, nag-training pa start yung negosyo nila, yung kumbaga, not really retirement, but di ba? Yung ipon nila, ipapanegosyo nila. That's a good sign. That means our yeast is alive. Tapos bababa yung yeast, that means the yeast is no longer alive. You cannot use that anymore. So this is the first step. It used to be a side, right? Kasi it started, our donuts started out May of 2022. So for a while, the main business is really the supplies and also the workshops. So and then, but now it's luckily, you know, things are coming together. So it's good. If we're talking about pizza equipment, we have a business package. That'd be 88,000. At the very least, that would be your initial. Plus, of course, any other ingredient like this one, cases, pizza peels. It also depends how nice you want the renovation to be. So, probably about, I don't know, 500 to about 1M. It'd be a good start. So, we'll make a batch. Flour, lahat, dump lang sa mixer. So, it's 1 kilo. Next, start. So you want to level everything out. 10 to 30 seconds, na mag-mix lang siya. Then add in our salt. Yeah, mag-mix lahat muna. Next, add in our water. So on the 7th minute mark, we add in our honey yeast mixture. Then, last ingredient, our olive oil. Okay, stop. Okay. Okay, we have our pizza dough. We're now bringing to the table. Before that, we don't want it to stick too much. We get a little bit of flour. And now we put it on top. Now we want to divide this into, in our case, 5 portions. So 5 12-inch pizzas for 1 kilo. Okay. So. Okay. So we'll cut smaller portion and then add to the weighing scale. For this recipe, ang target natin per pizza, we'll be using somewhere around 318 grams of dough. Okay. Once 318 na siya, okay na siya, tatabi na siya dito. And then we'll do the same for our other dough. We start out first with the basic, okay? So in this case, New York style basic, that New York style pizza, you mean like a basic kind of New York style pizza. Then from there, you can make adjustments. So we'd cover that more of our business discussion. So kung sasabihin niyo sa akin, okay, I want to target over the masses. Then, so go, I can suggest, okay, we can change kung cheese, pagkakaroon ng cheese, yung toppings, pwedeng palitan din, and so on and so forth. Para mag-match siya dun sa business goals ninyo. So we customize it towards the entrepreneur. Right? Because like you said, not everyone is the same. Eh? There are some entrepreneurs that want to target yung AB market, others like the CD market. So we do customize it. Ang gagawin natin ngayon is the dough ball natin. So we want to make it into a dough ball form. So we get one. First thing we do is we want to stretch out the pizza dough to make it a bit smooth. Okay. So we're stretching out only at the bottom here. So I'm pushing it in. And I want to smoothen out the top of the pizza. Okay. Once I do that, yung baba, I want to seal it to make it sort of like an empanada. Okay. Kung hindi kasi sealed yan, kapag nag-rise, mag-iiba siya ng position ng form. So I do want to seal it. And then yung sealed portion, ibababa ko siya sa table. And then I want to pinch the bottom portion of the dough. Okay. Pinch, and then I want to turn it. So, gaganon siya. So, mapapansin niyo, pag ginaganto ko, naging bola na siya. Okay. So, one of the reasons why kapag flinatin out siya, naging circle. It's even. Next, we want to have a separate container. And in the container, we want to add in a little bit of oil. In our case, we use olive oil. So just a little bit of olive oil. Then we have a silicone brush. We want to spread the oil so that pag nilagay natin yung dough, hindi siya madikit. Okay. Next, okay, we add in our dough here, there, and we give enough space for all the pizza doughs. Pandi talagang pag nag-rise siya, pag lumaki siya, hindi siya dikit-dikit. Okay, sir, I have a guess. Let's do this. So, yung dough, ipatong natin on our palms. Then yung fingers natin, pupush in while yung baba, okay, is open. Okay, so you want to stretch out this portion eh. You want to stretch it out, and then top of the palms is a seal natin at the top here. So let me explain again. Okay, so it's the dough is on our palms. Mm-hmm. Fingers will push in. Okay, yan. And then yung top palms, yan, bitaw, yan. And then ididikit natin yung taas lang. So nakatay na po yung pinakagitna dito. Hindi ko hinahawakan yung pinakataas lang. So gagawin natin yon about 3 to 4 times. Okay, so nakataas. Okay. Next, another way to do it is nakababa. So, okay. So, like this, start here. Okay. So from here, ipupush in natin yung fingers para mag-stretch out yung dough sa taas. Make sense? Okay. Next, we turn it. Okay, then we do the same thing. Fingers push in para mag-stretch. And then turn nyo po ulit. Okay. Now, we don't want to do it too much times. Enough lang mag-smoothen out siya. Smooth? We're good. Okay. Next, seal lang natin. Again, pang empanada. Okay. Kasi kailangan sealed talaga siya. This part, yan. Okay. Next. Okay. Itong sealed portion, nakababa sa table. Then, yung palms natin, nasa table mismo, so nakalatag. Then, ipipinch natin yung baba ng pizza dough. Okay, again, palms na nandito. Next, yung left hand, pataas, right hand, pababa.
Left hand, pataas,
right hand, pababa. So, nakapatong siya, no? Nakapatong. Okay, nakapinch. Left hand, pataas. Right hand, pababa. Yan. So, umiikot siya. Okay. Yan. So, the goal here is mabilog. Then, pag binaba natin, kailangan sealed pa rin to.
mas. Okay, konti pa. Okay, sealed. If ever, pwedeng i-seal na lang dyan. If hindi kasi sealed yon, posibleng bumuka siya. You're good?
Okay, next. Lagay natin sa container. So, medyo laking space. Then, kagandahan sa amin, we offer a limited training. So, again, the goal is kasi makapagbukas kayo yung negosyo eh. And sometimes, hindi mo nakuha lahat in one day. There are times mag-training ngayon after 1 year pa nagbubukas. So, minsan nakakalimutan, pwede mag-retraining sa amin, libre naman siya. We don't charge extra.
Really? Why?
Mm-hmm. Kasi the goal is really to start the business eh. There are some people na gusto nila malaman if pizza is gonna be the right business for me. So, kaya sila mag-enroll kasi gusto nilang malaman muna. And then, saka mag-iipon. So, ito yung dough na nakakagawa na natin. In a couple of hours, we want the dough to rise, mag-activate yung yeast. Magiging ganyan siya. Get one. Okay. Put it on. So, makoat lang lahat siya with flour. Then, put it here. So, first things first, we want to take out the air inside the dough. So, we do that by pressing up and down. So, we do this a few times until it's large enough. Then, we turn it around. Do the same thing. So, different kind of pizza would be pre-made by the dough already. It's going to be very different when it comes to the quality. And technically speaking, we also teach you how to make pre-made dough as well.
Would it be better to have a pre-made dough?
Depends on the market that you are targeting. If you're targeting possibly CD market and a specific price point, then that should be okay.
How much would it cost pre-made dough?
If I'm not mistaken, pre-made somewhere around 30 pesos per, 20 to 30 pesos per. Next, I want to slap around the dough here because I want to take out any excess flour. Okay. Next, I want to toss the dough. So, tossing will make it a little bit more even when it comes to. Okay. Next. Okay, we get our pizza screen. And then we check the size of the pizza. Again, the goal of what we're making right now is a 12-inch pizza. So it's a little bit more. We don't want to shortchange our clients, no? So we stretch out the pizza a bit.
Common problems of pizza owners.
Pizza owners. Well, first off, in general, it would be how much pizzas you're making on a daily basis. So inventory. You don't have any data. You don't know when's your peak, when it's not. So it's going to get a little bit used to yung market ninyo. Next, honestly, it's not really about the business itself, but more of people and staff. That's usually going to be a common problem. Training your staff, making sure you know everything is up to standard. That probably be the two most common things that's happening. One, fairly recent, ang nangyari sa kanya is she paid. So she was an investor. She was an investor. Her and her friends. Kasunduan nila is yung client na to will be paying for the training as well as the equipment. So funding everything. Yung kaibigan niya, sila yung magtatao, sila yung mag-manage talaga ng location. I think that started, 2 years ago eh. Then, for about 6 months, it was doing well. After noon, nag-dip yung sales nila. Short stories, eventually, yung mga business partner nila found a different opportunity. Eh, since they didn't really put money in, well, tumakbo sila. Not tumakbo, but they lost interest. So, nangyari, itong kliyente namin, now does not know anything about the business. Meron siyang equipment, meron siyang mga tao, but does not know anything about it. So, I guess the one of the things there is, the moral there is, that even if, you know, may business partner ka, it would still be good to know something about the business. So that if ever man magka-away or something happens, you know how to run it. I think she had to stop for about a month. Month or a month and a half. Tigil operations. So, papaswalo pa siya mga tao. So, talo-talo. So, Puhunan, as far as equipment is concerned, like I said, we do have a business package. It is currently on promo for 88,000. So, what you would need there for start a pizza business, of course, equipment-wise, is, of course, your mixer. You saw that a while ago. Mixer, we have your pizza peels, pizza screens. Screen is like this one here. So, pizza screen. And then, of course, your pizza oven. Okay. After that, depending on the style of your business, kung takeout counter ba yan, or let's say it's a dine-in place, so of course you need your furnitures, your plates, and so on and so forth. Depending, if it's a small business, a takeout counter, you'll probably get into about, I'd say about 250. 250 will be a good starting point, initial capital. If you're going to go for a full-size restaurant, somewhere in the, around the 1 million to 1.5. A little bit above pala 88,000 because you need boxes pa. So it would include the equipment. And then you'd get your boxes. Technically starting out, if you want like really, really minimum, pwedeng not really printed boxes yet, pwedeng stickers lang nakalagay for branding. And then just open up a Facebook page or Grab or something like that. Yeah. The manual way to do it is to mix it by hand. What we did a while ago in Bisna 8 minutes, it'll probably take you somewhere around 20 to 30 minutes. You don't have mixer that time. Really, it's just mixing everything together. Ang ano mo nun, pawis lang.
Okay. What you would need though is, out of the equipment, would be your oven, of course. So either you have a brick. Although now I don't think it's as common, no. In regular sized oven, it won't cook it as good. You need a certain kind of temperature, and sort of certain kind of heat retention within your oven. But if we're talking about just saying that, let's say, gagawa kayo ng 10 pizzas, 8 pizzas per day. Most home ovens, it should be able to handle it.
Eden quick melt kind of cheese. Currently, I think per kilo is somewhere around 350 per kilo. Then higher end would be more mozzarella, pure mozzarella. It would run you somewhere around 500 to about 500-600 pesos per kilo. Ang ginagawa ng iba is they mix cheese. If you want to have mozzarella still, but then mix a little bit of cheddar or, you know, pang masa na cheese, pwede naman.
Pepperoni.
Real pepperoni is a bit expensive. I think this one, if I'm not mistaken, is about 600, 700 per kilo. There are some that want to be known na medyo kakaibang flavors, no? I'd say at the very least, it should have, of course, your cheese, pepperoni, all meat. That's probably like a supreme kind of vegetables and meat. And of course, vegetables. Those are the kind of flavors that if bago ka lang sa shop na yon, medyo ayaw mo mag-experiment, you'd probably gravitate towards those flavors. Okay? So, lagyan natin sa loob. Four minutes, but total of 6 to 8 minutes cooking time. The reason why we split into two is because we want to turn the pizza around on the fourth minute mark. Higher end market, you can probably get away with somewhere around the 7 to 80% markup. Lower pang masa, you'd probably go maybe around 60%, something like that. But depending on your style, depending on, again, the market you're targeting. I know of clients that sell their pizzas, say, for 450 pesos. Yung puhunan nila doon is somewhere, if I'm not mistaken, it was 140. So you're looking at somewhere around 310 pesos per pizza. So if you pull up my trusty calculator, if the competition a while ago is we make 310 pesos per pizza, for example, we sell, well, minimum, say, 10 pizzas per day. Okay, 3,100, we're open, let's say, for example, 25 days in a month. That will give us a gross profit of 77,500. If we deduct, for example, yung rent natin, for example, 20,000, we deduct, let's say, labor. You're making one pizza per hour, kahit isang tao lang. If not, dapat ikaw lang gumagawa nun. 13,000, if you're gonna deduct, let's say, another kuryente, let's say it's 15,000. Meron kayong water, 1,000. And for whatever reason, you have miscellaneous expenses, let's say 15,000, that would still give you an earning of 13,500. So the good thing about the pizza business is per pizza, you do make a healthy gross profit. So you don't really need to sell, you know, sobrang daming pizzas. Eh. But again, this is if you're going for the higher end market, AB, you can have a higher profit percentage. So it depends kung ang area nyo ba is madami ba dun ang higher end market and yung competition din. Are they set in their ways? May pizza shop ba dun na decades na siya nandun? And how hard do you think it is to penetrate that market? So, we have... Again, like I said, 4th minute mark. We want to spin or turn the pizza. So, yung nasa likod, gusto natin iharap. Oops, sorry. Kasi yung heating element niya, mas mainit siya sa likod. Okay. And then, timer. Another 4 minutes. So, total of 6 to 8 minutes. So, for example, this oven, this is the one that's in our package, more insulated, yung heat niya, so it wouldn't take that long. If it was a home oven, posibleng aabot yung mga 12 minutes, plus preheating. Usually, we go into yung location na binabalak nila. So, ano yung location na yun? Usually, pwedeng i-Google map namin. Then, tingnan namin yung area, possible foot traffic. And then, we can give them a computation on earning potential. After that, we'll be more specific na to them. Give them tips on their marketing, how to start it. Other things we discuss in our business discussion, we go into details to say marketing, how their tips on how to market their shop. If they have competition, give them tips on how to separate themselves from the competition and so on and so forth. Okay, next it's almost done, right? A little bit light brown on top. We want to take out the pizza screen. And we do a direct heat. This is a fitted for a pizza oven. So it has a pizza stone, which will give you an additional texture at the bottom of your pizza. Okay. Then we close and we wait for about a couple of seconds. Okay. Let's get this nice color at the bottom. And that is a pepperoni New York style pizza.
So how can they compete with mga iba nang existing?
First, find out what are the strengths of those other pizza shops. Are they a different market? Because while they're both pizza, they might target a different market. If so, you don't really need to make them a problem. Because you can just open yours as is. I mean, one, is it a price point? You can also taste their product. Is yours better? So things like that. Talagang hihimain mo talaga what your strengths will be, and ano yung mga strengths ng mga competition. At the same time, if you have additional value, if ang location ninyo is near school, if yours is closer, things like that. Cut. So real New York style pizza should have that crunch. Okay. Yeah, dig in. First, are you going to, who are you going to target? Are you going to target more of events, more of birthday parties ba yan? If so, then you'd like to make your pizza a bit bigger, mga 18-inch, 16-inch pizzas. If ang target niyo is small families, then you'd go for a smaller size pizza. Once you know kung ano yung target market niyo, then you try to establish ano ba yung habits ng mga market niyo. Usually, I'd say if I were to suggest marketing, majority of the time it would be digital marketing. So learn or do Facebook ads. Ngayon TikTok, it's here to stay. Hindi naman kailangan magsayaw-sayaw sa TikTok. It's not about that. You can just highlight your products, highlight what makes your special, and then also don't forget to not only sell your product. So aside from the product you're selling, you're also selling a brand. So you want to add something else. What makes your brand different? Are you, again, a family-friendly brand? If so, you want to show customers who are eating there as a family, all smiles. And you want to, when you establish also your brand, you want to stick to it. So consistency. You need to be always consistent. How you use yung words ninyo, yung mga captions, everything needs to fit one brand. So, sir, kuha po tayo ng isa. Okay, make sure na hindi na nasisira yung shape. Then, lagyan natin sa flour. Angat natin yung pizza dough. Then, lagyan natin sa flour. Makover lahat ng
buho.
Yes. Yan. So, hindi siya madikit. Okay, pato natin. Then, we want to press yung dough. Oops. Medyo strong si sir eh, no? So, we want to do up and down. Okay, so up and down. Yan. Okay. So, we don't want to force yung pizza na pa-circle. One reason why ito, medyo nag-oblong siya. When starting out your business, we usually suggest dapat lagi ka nandun. At least for the first 6 months. So you need to know it inside out. There's no way around it. That's first. Next, likely, ang mangyayari po niyan, madaming makakita ng either a success ninyo. So you can expect in the beginning, people will ask how you're doing it, and possibly magaya ka din. It's common eh. When people see that you're doing well, they want to also, you know, benefit from that eh. So expect also na may mga posibleng gumaya din. Other things is you don't want to stop innovating. So hindi ang negosyo kasi is not the kind of thing na you simulan mo then iwan mo. People kung nasarapan sila ngayon, after for example 5 months na kinakain nila yan, they want something different. They want other ingredients, other kinds of food, other kinds of flavors. So you also want to keep innovating. Now that it's larger, you can do slapping. Ito natin yung flour. And then, usually here, we suggest tossing. One hand. Hindi, no. Malay nyo, sir, hindi pa nasusubukan. Subukan muna natin bago natin, no. So, okay, yan. That's the spirit. So, here, right hand, nakababa dito. Dito yung dough, no? Okay. So the goal is, pang half moon. So mag-wave tayo. Yung dough, nandito pa rin. At the top, yung fingers natin, if you flick natin yung dough. So the goal is, again, umikot siya. We want centrifugal force to spread out the dough evenly. Okay, oops. So nangyayari dyan, when you're winding, tumitigil ka dito. No? Hindi, you want to go all the way here. So dapat here, bumibilis ka pa. Hindi tumitigil. Ayan, okay. So, ang ginagawin mo kasi kanina, you stop here. So, ganyan lang siya. What you want is, you want it to
fly,
yes. So, tutuloy nyo talaga yung pag-spin para umiikot siya. Okay. So, from the bottom here, may momentum. You want to... And then here, the wrist, fingers, you want to flick it. Para talaga mag-spin siya. That's okay. So, anong nangyayari dito, tumitigil kayo dito. So, if dito kayo tumitigil, di siya nagsispin. You want sa taas mismo. Oops, okay. One example. So, nabuta siya, which is pretty common. It's okay for dough, it's you can just seal it. That should be okay. Ibig na sabihin nun, kapag nag-toss ka, nakalabas yung kamay. Either nakaganon siya. Kaya talagang mabuta siya. You don't want nakalatag ng ganon. Another way is you stretch it by hand. So, you stretch out the dough very gently nang hindi siya nasisira. So, for example, there are some that for example, may pinagkakatiwalaan sila na employee. Some of the employees, they go to us kasama ng training. Nalalaman kung kung saan supplies, magkano yung puhunan, magkano yung kita. And it has happened that tinatabihan sila ng gawa. To a certain level, you have to, of course, trust your employees. But there's also a way to sort of safeguard whatever secrets you have. So you want to have a compartmentalize some of the information you know to protect yourself as well. Others, it's usually competition. Again, lumalakas yung pizza shop. Biglang ginagaya siya. So with that, one of the best ways to do that is early on, you have to invest in your customer experience. So you have a head start . For example, lumakas nga ka, tapos yung competitor mo, nagbuka siya lower price. So what you should have been doing is establishing relationship with your customers. Sometimes having inside jokes if possible, kung ganun, no? Talagang may connection na. If possible, you can also get like their emails, their contact information. So if ever you have any marketing to be doing, you can also contact them directly, things like that. Usually, more often than not, yung business would fail usually based on either mismanagement or operations na talaga. Kasi, for example, if you have a good recipe, if you have a good product, usually it sells for itself . It's not always going to be a straight line going up. Hindi siya pang, when you're an employee, kasi every month you know kung magkano yung kita mo. So sometimes, talagang sasagad mo . Yung buong budget mo for the month, sasagad mo. Business, you can't do that. You have to expect there are high months, there are low months. So you can't get caught that yung akala mong magiging high month siya is, you don't save, you don't plan for it. So that probably the biggest change as well. Planning when you are a business owner. Well, here, especially in our place, whether it be the pizza or any kind of business or even donuts, we're not afraid to try and possibly na magkamali talaga. Whether it be changing the recipe a bit, whether it be different kind of marketing. For example, during the pandemic, everything shifted online. So we used to have a video and photo guy na nag-quit. So kami mismo, we learned how to do video editing. We learned how to do photos. We learned how to do things that we're not comfortable with. Especially for a small business, you can't just hire people to do it. For example, you have a limited budget, it'd be better if you know it. At least base. And then you can hire if you have other, you know, more efficient, more better things to do.
Okay. Having been an employee muna for quite a bit, so I started working ng 18. We actually applied for our very first call center together. Found out gonna be a dad at 18. I started working. Dumating sa point actually na I had like, if I'm not mistaken, 5 jobs all at once. Kasi at that time, if you guys are, I don't know if any of you are old enough, pero kasi nung time namin, or nung time ko, degree was, it was a bit more important back then eh. So to, for example, para magtrabaho ka sa food, kailangan tipong ano ka, HRM man lang at the very least, and so on. But obviously, having been an undergrad, it was hard to find work. So I tried to do whatever I can, but then eventually landed in the call center. Medyo sinwerte, nakapag call center, nakaipon. Had a really good boss at the last call center that I was in, the last company that I was in. Unfortunately, that boss passed away. And medyo nawalan ako ng gana mag-work. I guess it felt na it was time na subukan ko naman to gamble on myself. So with my very little ipon at the time, as a matter of fact, was literally exacto 200,000. Tried to venture into the food business kasi I grew up in food eh. My mom is a restaurateur for more than 40 years. So she has a restaurant. I grew up around the restaurant, in a restaurant rather. So parang, I guess, because of familiarity na rin, I went and ventured into food. So I had a small store na basically food cart lang siya at that time na I was selling shomai or selling dumplings in that food cart. Pero I was looking for a drink kasi this was situated in Lasal, around the Lasal area. So I was thinking I wanted a more social na inumin. I didn't want the traditional shomai and shomai and gulaman. So nasakto naman my wife, she was coming home from Singapore at that time. She visited her sister sa Singapore. And she told me about this brand. Sabi niya sa akin, alam mo, there's this store here. 9 o'clock pa nagbubukas, pero 8 o'clock nakapila ng mga tao. Name ng brand na yon is Gongcha. Yon, I can mention them. So I told her, or I asked her, sabi ko, what are they selling? Sabi niya, itong milk tea thing na to, so bubble tea. And at that time, you gotta understand, here in the Philippines, that was not known. The closest one we have sa milk tea dati was the Pearl Cool Shake. So, wala pang miski na ano nito dati. So, I researched, I tried to learn. Obviously, wala pang nag-YouTube niyan, walang anything. Nataon lang na I knew somebody from Taiwan, whom I asked, does he know any idea kung paano ang gawin ng milk tea ganyan? He gave me some pointers, parang an idea lang. Apparently, it's a regular drink doon. And I started to make that here. And when I was okay na doon sa pinakalasa na nagawa ko, nilagay ko siya doon sa store na yun. So again, you gotta understand, this was like a 2x2 type, food cart lang. And then it got to a point na yung cart na yun, people were starting to go there for the milk tea, not for the food. So that's when I started to think na baka mas may market tong drink na to. Maybe I should concentrate here. So what I did is I concentrated there. But then shortly after, I had this one customer na daily pinupuntahan ako and was telling me, alam mo, ang sarap nung drinks mo. I think there's a business that can be made here. Meron din siya asawang Taiwanese kasi. So as far as logistics is concerned, mapapadali sa kanila magdala ng ingredients dito. They asked me if I am willing to let them franchise my brand. I told them I didn't know anything about that at that time. Kasi eventually I did start to make franchising companies for people, pero at that time I didn't know anything pa. So I told them, if you want, we can go into sort of an arrangement na lang where I teach you everything you need to know and you just pay me. Medyo sinuwerte, we built their business, it became at papano well known, and their name started to carry me as well. Kasi the good thing about this brand is hindi sila nagpapa-franchise. All of the branches that they have all over the Philippines right now are theirs. So when people ask them na, "Oy, how can I franchise?" Hindi sila madamot. They literally just throw that business to me. O, ito si RP, Jess, siya magtuturo sa inyo. When my now wife and I were dating pa lang, nag-live-in kasi muna kami bago kami nagpaasal, Chris was actually one of our roommates as well. So tatlo kami nag-roommate kami in a small one-bedroom condo. We were sleeping on the floor. So if you went in dun sa, ano namin, sa house namin, no? Which was, the one-room condo, we had nothing there, not even a TV, walang, no, nothing. Literally, we had mga unan lang. Ikaw, wala kang unan eh.
Wala unan.
Kami lang ng wife, kami unan. And kumot. And we slept on the floor. So that's how it started sa amin, really. Sa business naman, it wasn't all, tipong butterflies and rainbows. Talagang yung sinabi ko na food cart na inopen ko, I made one very big mistake na nung nakakita ako ng isang buwan na maganda, akala ko it was all gonna be maganda, I opened like 3 additional stores agad-agad. So nag-expand ako agad-agad, and remember, I only have 200K at this point, so that's not really a lot of money. In-expand ko into 4 branches agad. So basically, I spread myself too thin. And one by one, long story short, nagsara sila up until I got that one branch na lang na natitira dyan sa May Lasal. So out of desperation, I wanted that branch to be super maganda. And that's when yung kinwento ko kanina, that's when we came up with a milk tea drink to pair and etc. And the rest is history. You gotta understand, I've been training entrepreneurs for 11 years. So, medyo marami-rami na talaga. And it's cool, really. It's come to a point na if I go to a place wherever in Manila, there's always a place I can visit. Or wherever in the Philippines, rather. There's always a place I can visit na meron kaming kliyente sa lugar na yun. So, that's nice. One thing you gotta understand din sa milk tea dati, 11 years ago, 12 years ago, ang nakakaalam lang ng milk tea, in short, may pera. Kasi normally, these are the people who travels sa labas. Kasi wala naman milk tea sa Philippines eh. So if you came back here and you know what milk tea is, tendency is, at the very least, nakakaikot ka sa Asia. Taiwan, Hong Kong, Singapore, mga ganyan. So back then, the clientele ng milk tea, if in a word, medyo may pera. So I basically, it generated a lot of business for me na gusto magpaturo, willing to pay. Willing to wait, yung mga ganun. Kasi at that time, since one-man operation lang naman ako, I only took on 2 clients per 3 months. So, dumating sa stage na I had a waiting list for an entire year. Mga 6 to 8 clients lang ako niyan per year. Pero kasi at that time, package na in-offer ko is from scratch eh. Tipong literally, ultimo renovation ng store mo, oversee ko, training ng tao mo, oversee ko. Yung pag-aayos ng supplies mo from Taiwan to Philippines, oversee ko. All of that, inaayos ko dati yun eh. So I don't sell products yet at that time. But when eventually I got to sell products na, that's when we open yung training lang. Ikaw na magagawa ng renovation mo, etc. Yung kung ano yung nakikita natin ngayon. Marami na kasing gumaya nung style namin.
So at the moment, we have 4 trainings. So we're planning to add more trainings. Hopefully, we do a bread course and ramen. Go back to our ramen. So after offering more trainings, maybe going back into our online training as well. Online trainings, hopefully in online course as well.
Number one advice I give people na nag-iisip pumasok sa negosyo would be to just start. The number one advice would be to start. Stop overthinking things. Kasi a lot of times, we have the tendency of uumpisahan ko na lang kapag ganito na, when there are a lot of conditions that are met. But the reality is, it will never turn out the same na you imagined it. Good for you if pag-umpisa pa lang from day one, perfect na siya. Pero tendency is, that's not what's going to happen. So as such, I would say, umpisahan mo na muna and just learn how to make adjustments on the fly. So that's how real entrepreneurs really do it, and that's how real businesses happen talaga.
For me, bago magsimula, I guess may say you're starting already. It probably won't be like specific business related, but I'd say to find and create a good support system. So starting a business is gonna be pretty hard. You're gonna be doing things na hindi mo alam kung gagana ba siya o hindi. At paminsan, you can start to lose hope. You can start to think that mali yung ginawa mo. So it's good to have a good support system. People that you trust, people who can be there. So if you want to learn more, if you want to get trained by us, you can search for us on Facebook, Instagram, search for Argonza Trading. You can also Google us, you can see our numbers there and our address if you want to drop by. We are hoping to be like a one-stop shop, so aside from the training, we have several packages for the businesses. Pizza, milk tea, coffee, and flavored rice. So we have, it's a complete package including equipment and also training.